Welcome back for another video that will show a proof of one of the properties of hyperbolic functions. So again, by now, we should be familiar with the six hyperbolic functions defined here. So let's go ahead and focus on the property that we're going to prove. We've already proved a couple of these properties, but in this video, we're going to focus on this property here, which actually, because of the plus or minus sign, is actually two properties. So in this video, we'll focus on the sum identity for the hyperbolic sine function, meaning we'll prove hyperbolic sine of x plus y is equal to hyperbolic sine of x times hyperbolic cosine of y plus hyperbolic cosine of x times hyperbolic sine of y. So let's go ahead and get started. For the first step, we're going to go ahead and write each hyperbolic function in exponential form. And if needed, I provided the definitions here below for hyperbolic cosine of x and hyperbolic sine of x. So for hyperbolic sine of the quantity x plus y, we're going to replace x with x plus y in this exponential form here. So we'll have e raised to the power of x plus y minus e to the power of the opposite of the quantity x plus y divided by 2. And on the right side, we would have hyperbolic sine of x, which is e to the x minus e to the negative x divided by 2, times hyperbolic cosine of y, which would be e to the y plus e to the negative y divided by 2, plus hyperbolic cosine of x, which is e to the x plus e to the negative x divided by 2. And then hyperbolic sine of y would be equal to e to the y minus e to the negative y divided by 2. And now for our proof, we're going to focus on making the right side equal to the left side. So we're going to find the product here, add the two fractions, and hopefully show the right side is equal to the left side. And just to review, when multiplying and the bases are the same, we will be adding the exponents. So to find this first product, notice if we multiply the denominators, our denominator would be 4. And then for the numerator, we'll have four products, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So e to the x times e to the y would be e to the power of x plus y. And then we have e to the x times e to the negative y. Again, we're adding the exponents. We would have plus e to the x minus y. Now we have two more products. Next we have negative e to the negative x times e to the y. That's going to be minus e to the negative x plus y. And then finally we have negative e to the negative x times e to the negative y, which would be minus e to the negative x minus y plus, again we'll have four products, 1, 2, 3, 4. So e to the x times e to the y is e to the x plus y. And then we have e to the x times negative e to the negative y. It's going to be minus e to the x minus y. We have two more products. E to the negative x times e to the y. It's going to be plus e to the negative x plus y. And then finally we have e to the negative x times negative e to the negative y. It's going to be minus e to the negative x minus y. Notice how we do have a common denominator, so we'll go ahead and add the two fractions. We'll have a denominator of 4, and now we'll combine the like terms. So these two terms are like terms. Remember the coefficients are 1, so the sum would be 2 times e to the power of x plus y. Remember when adding, the exponents aren't going to change. Notice how this term and this term are also like terms, but they're also opposites. Therefore, the sum would be equal to 0. Next, this term and this term are like terms. But again, notice how they're opposites. One's negative and one's positive. Therefore, their sum would be 0. And then finally, these two terms are like terms. And they both have a coefficient of negative 1. Which means the sum would be negative 2 e to the negative x minus y, or minus 2 e to the negative x minus y. Notice how the two terms in the numerator have a common factor of 2. Let's go ahead and factor the 2 out. That would leave us with e to the x plus y minus e to the, I'm also going to factor out a negative from the exponent. That would be negative, and this would change the sign of the x and the y, so we have negative the quantity x plus y all over 4. 2 and the 4 simplify. This simplifies to a 1, this simplifies to a 2. So now we have our proof, because notice how the simplified right side of this equation is equal to the left side of the equation. So we have our proof. We've shown that e to the power of x plus y minus e to the power of the opposite of the quantity x plus y divided by 2 is equal to the right side, which again is just e to the x plus y minus e to the power of negative the quantity x plus y divided by 2. So this proves the initial property. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.